Good morning, friends. I'm here with a SheGlam first impressions. SheGlam is Shein's makeup brand. I have just been seeing it all over TikTok and I wanted to try it because it's very affordable. The colors look cute. The applicators look cute. Genuinely excited to dive on in, see what we've got. I'm probably just gonna do my base as I normally would. I'm going to use a foundation that is discontinued. Story of my life. Okay, so it turns out I actually only have blushes, a bronzer, and lipsticks, like lip products. And I've done my brows, obviously. I used my yet to be released Lounge Face products. So unbelievably excited for those to come out. They're like, oh, so good. This is the SheGlam Color Bloom Liquid Blush. So we've got Rose Ritual and Hush Hush. We all know I'm not a huge liquid blush gal, but that's okay. It just means that if it's a great product and I actually like it, then it must be amazing. First of all, first impressions, quality is great, packaging is great. This cost me, I think, $6.30. I had a coupon, as you do with Shein, so everything becomes even more affordable. Got some little logo, that's how it looks. Feels sturdy. Custom packaging like this is kind of expensive because you need a really high minimum order quantities. So I guess I can get away with it because a lot of people are ordering. So I'm gonna start with Rose Ritual on my white side. Now I think it has, yeah, it has a really cool applicator. Doesn't really smell like anything. It smells more like vanilla, if anything, which is nice. I'm going to grab a synthetic brush to blend this out. Now I'm going to apply it straight to my cheek, which I don't really like the idea of, but let's just go for it. I'm just trying to like stipple this. I'm not trying to swipe or go like this because that will be the quickest way to remove my foundation, which it is already kind of doing, but I will give it the benefit of the doubt that I do have my fair skin on today. So it's easy to see mistakes or error, like flaws, I guess, when I've got fair skin. But there's something about a tan that just disguises everything. The color itself is nice. I like that it doesn't feel dewy, it doesn't feel sticky, and it's not too glowy or shiny, which is nice. I would still probably go in with a brush straight to the applicator and then dab off some of the excess so that I'm not applying concentrated products straight to my cheek. But this still, considering, you know, I did apply really obvious pink dots to my cheek, you can't really see where they were, but granted, I've also taken off my foundation, so I'm not sure if you'd see regardless. I also just realized that I've skipped a product by accident. I'm going to use the contour on my forehead. I'm not going to use it underneath my cheeks because it's going to probably interfere with the blush color a little bit. I would apply it last, if anything, like after my blush, but I mean, I'll try it. There's no harm in that, right? So let's do Hush Hush on the left side. I can see why this has become very popular on TikTok. It feels like a great quality product and the price is ridiculous and the finish is nice. Like, that is actually a really nice finish for a blush for me because I don't like it when they're very dewy. It still has that shine, but to the touch, like, it feels no different to the foundation that I haven't set, which is really nice because like I could happily go out of the house and not set this, which is a big deal for me. So that's pretty cool. This color looks stunning. I love this kind of color. I kind of want to put it all over my lips, but let's not do that. Ooh, this is nice. I can tell. Ooh, that is really nice. A lot more subtle, which is my jam, especially when I've got fair skin. I need to add another dab, which is interesting compared to the last one. I guess the last one is a lot brighter, so you can spread it further because you don't want it to be too bright. But if it's already a more subtle color, you can get away with applying a bit more. I'm gonna use this applicator for both sides so that the application was the same. This is a really great product. Yeah, no wonder it's all over TikTok. that's that side. I'll turn off my pink light in case that is skewing the color at all. So that's that side, super natural, and that's that side, a lot more pinky. Gosh, that's stunning. That's so natural. That's more like I've just been to the gym and I've got rosacea, like that's kind of like peeking through my cheek, which is fine, but I much prefer this. All right, pink light back on. And now I'm gonna go in with this product, which is the She Glam Sun Sculpt Liquid Contour in Soft Tan. I'm also not big on contouring when I haven't got a tan because it just doesn't do anything for me. That's the packaging, very cute. I like that it's a subtle color change from the blush shade. Like, you know, you got a little bit of more of a gray base. That's actually quite a good sign so far. That is quite a gray. I don't know if it's just the packaging, could be, but we'll see when we open it up. Wow, that's really gray. So that would actually look quite, let me just do one little dab. Two little dabs. That's a very gray contour. Ooh, I just did what I said I wasn't gonna do, which is swipe. I can't really tell if that did anything. You guys will have to let me know. It's a lot harder to blend this out because it's, I don't want to blend it too far, so I kind of have to push and, I mean, that one looks a bit more obvious, doesn't it? But does it look muddy? It blends out pretty well as well, considering, oh, good itch, good itch, good itch. I did a little bit there because I want it to go further back to my ear. Okay, cool. Let's try the forehead, shall we? So this is the kind of color that you want. Oh, I have to be really quick with them. This is the kind of color that you want when it comes to fair skin. I know I won't shut up about my fair skin, but it's just, it's relevant to the conversation we're having. Okay, so it's probably not best for my forehead because my forehead, if it did tan, which it wouldn't, it's gonna be more of like a pinky contour. Not pinky contour, it's gonna be more of a, it's gonna have warmth to it. It's not gonna be cool like this, but you want the cool underneath your cheekbones because that mimics a shadow and shadows aren't warm. Shadows are very grayish cool. It works well for the under here, but not that great for the forehead. Yeah, I mean, it's fine. I don't really contour my nose or anything, so I'm not gonna try and do that now. But that's pretty cool. I'm really impressed with the color of that. That is really, well, let me see what the actual packaging says. It probably doesn't say that it's a bronzer. Yeah, it's a liquid contour, so it's Sun Sculpt. But if you're mentioning the sun, then you kind of imply that it's from, you know, you're being warmed by the sun. So this is definitely not that. But if you are fair and you do want some kind of contouring product, I think this would be worth trying out, considering how cheap it is as well. It's like you don't really have a whole lot to lose. And I do think the chances that you would like it are quite high. Are we keeping these? Yeah, for sure. I think these are great products to have in my little collection. I didn't buy a highlighter. I kind of wish I did now because I'm impressed with these so far, but I'm just not really a highlighter girl. Liquid highlighter, they look too blinding for me. So are the rest of these actually just lip products? Yeah. I'm going to put mascara on and I will come back to you and we'll try on the lip products. I'm back. I used Lounge Face Lash, of course, for my mascara. I didn't show it because it's not a first impression. I don't really know where to begin. I have so many different, products to choose from. These are both the same, just in different shades. One's in Soft Chai, one's in Praline Pie. Glam 101 Lipstick and Liner Duo. I'm gonna try the one that seems to be the best match for my skin tone, because some of these are probably more suited to when I have a tan, some of them not so much. Okay, so this one's been like broken in the component, whereas this one, yeah, that one's gonna be way too dark. So we'll put the lid back on him. Oh, there we go, I can just turn it around. It just came loose. but I still can't. Oh, no, I can adjust it now. Okay, I think crisis has been averted. So this is the shade Praline Pie. We'll start with a lip liner. This packaging feels a little bit cheaper. Well, it's really easy to apply because that was a nice application. Not sure if you can tell, but my lips have a bit of a purpley tone to them, so I'm forever on the hunt for the perfect lip liner for my the perfect, like, your lips but better shade. More so for fair skin because it's easier to make a lipstick work when you've got a tan for some reason. Okay, this has completely fallen down the bottom of the... Oh, wow. Oh, wow. Okay. It's actually completely broken off. I'm gonna try and just, yeah, force it back in there, I guess. Very matte. The color is actually quite nice, to be fair. It's so crazy to think that when I was younger, it's not crazy actually, I still do like the look of it, but I used to go for the like completely nude lip look. But now that I'm older, I actually really like having a darker lip shade because it, I don't know, it makes your lips a feature and accentuates them, which is nice. So that's that shade, Praline Pie. It is quite nice. Let me turn off the light. It's actually a really nice shade. How does it feel? It's definitely matte, but it's not particularly drying. It's quite a nice feeling, and this color is really growing on me. I really like that shade. I wonder how it looks when I dab some of it off to make it more of a natural lip. It actually reminds me of a product by another brand that I think has been discontinued. The color is really nice. Jeez, it was really clinging to my lips. I'm trying to take it off, but it's not really coming off, which is kind of great. Let me do the kiss test. Mm. Yeah. And I really pushed. Wow, Shein. That's really nice. And I like that. It doesn't really feel like I'm wearing anything on my lips, but I still have that color. Mmm. I'm really impressed with that. Now I just don't know how to get it off. I can really try and scrub it off. We're on to the Chic Lamb So Lippy lip liner. I've got True Faith and Concrete Jungle. I think Concrete Jungle looks like, it may have looked like a good color for my fair skin. The packaging is nice. It has the soft matte finish that all of the Lounge Base products have. Well, you guys have only seen the mascara, but that nice soft feeling. Sturdy packaging, feels really nice. So that is 03. Oh, that's annoying. Okay, so it says 527 on the back of the lid here, which is Concrete Jungle. Which is the one that I thought would be, oh gosh, that's very concrete-y. Oh my god. 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 Let me just see first. What? I can't believe that might be one of the closest lip shades I've ever used. At least for my fair skin. And it's called Concrete Jungle, and the color is, I was saying, that looks very concrete-y. I'm not gonna be able to show you. Okay, before I start raving about this product,
I'd like to add a disclaimer in, and I'm so glad that I tried this lip liner again after I filmed this, because I had a completely different experience. Every single time I've applied it since, completely different experience. I'm not sure if these pink lights like kind of made the lip liner more of my natural lip color, but when I've been trying it outside of this environment, it looks completely different than it did in the video. The video, it looked perfect. In real life, it does look like an orangey, browny, concretey. I don't like you saying concrete. It's not concrete. It's more of a rusty kind of color. Rust, that's a better example. I'll show you in a video after this. So do not go rush and buy this after. I'm going to be raving about it like it's the best thing I've ever put on my face ever in a second. Take it with a grain of salt. It did not look like that after I tried it in a different situation, different lighting. I also haven't applied it with a full face of makeup. Maybe that's why it looked a bit better. But the only time I've applied it since is with like a very, very light foundation or concealer around my face. So I don't know if that also changes it, but I haven't really been reaching for it since because the color actually isn't right after all. And I just wanted to share that.
Battery just died, but holy smokes. Holy smokes. Oh my God. I'm so unbelievably shocked to my core. Shocked to the core. I'm gonna zoom in from further away. I thought that could do a better perception of the color rather than just going super close to the camera. Oh, I don't think you can see. I want, I'll smile, because then it stretches my lips out. You can barely tell. I mean, maybe when I'm editing, I'll be able to tell more, but what on earth is happening right now? What the hell is happening? No wonder I haven't found my perfect lip liner shade. I've been looking at the wrong shade. I should be looking for like concrete colors. Apparently that's the color of my lips. Why is this called Concrete Jungle? It's like, oh my God. Whoa. Bonus points for the fact that it's a wind up lip pencil too. I hate lip liners that need to be sharpened. It's messy and it's annoying. Wow. I'm gonna color my lips in. It definitely is slightly more of a, it's got slightly more of a brownish tint. When I do it like this, you can see it's got more of a brownish tint when I color it all in. I mean, look, it does look okay. Oh, okay. When I color it all in like that, it does tend to look a bit more concretey. But fair gals will know that I prefer it to look like this and be slightly more cool toned than have it be pink, orange, red, any of those colors look bad. Whereas this, it's the same thing with this product. You need that cool tone to make it look natural, especially for fair skin. Wowee. Okay, just for comparison, just for funsies, let me take all of that off, which is not fun. Okay, let's try the other shade. Hey, let me try 03 True Faith. This one is a lot pinkier. Yeah. I'm not even gonna finish it because it's way too pink. Let me just do a comparison side by side so I can prove my point. So that's the pinky one, and this is Concrete Jungle. See how, can you tell? You can see when I do this, how much that blends into my lips. Whereas this one, it looks just pink. It doesn't define my lips because it's obviously the wrong shade. So it just looks like I've got the wrong color lipstick on. Whereas this one actually makes my lips look bigger because it mimics the same color of my lips. Pout Perfect Lip Plumper. That sounds fun. The best lip plumper, or it's not even, I don't think it's even marketed as a lip plumper, but it's the Makeup by Mario one. God, I love that. It's such a beautiful, it's like a balm, but it goes on your lips as a gloss, but without that annoying glossy feeling. Your lips just look like... Okay, let's see what this one looks like. We got the shade Pink Flamingo. Ooh, has that kind of holographic... You're not gonna be able to see, are you? Stunning. Wow, this looks like the same packaging as Makeup by Mario in terms of it has the same... It's different, like, overall packaging, but its form is the same. Like, it's in the same slanted... It's got the same slanted packaging. It kind of goes in on itself a little bit. It's like concave here, which is really annoying with the Makeup by Mario one. So if I push up, what does pushing up do? Okay, I think I'm slowly moving it up. That's interesting that it's not a wind up one. It smells like coconut. It smells like sunscreen with coconut in it. Wow, no wonder everyone's raving about Shein makeup. Jeez. This, I swear to God, this is the same formula as the Makeup by Mario one. I am speechless. How much does this cost? This is wild. $6.30. $7 full price. I will say this does taste like you've got sunscreen on your mouth. I can't believe this. This is exactly what I was just saying about the Makeup by Mario one. It is identical, I swear. Even the way it looks after you've used it is the same. Come on, focus. Same as the Makeup by Mario one. It looks glossy, wet. Everything I... Oh my God, so funny. I hate the taste of it though. Wow, I'm gonna... Oh my God, imagine this combined with the lip liner. Oh. Been this speechless in a long time when it comes to makeup, because I can't get over the price point. Like, how are you gonna charge $7 for this? How much did this cost to make? I would just love to know their profit margins on this. And it's made in China, which means that it'll be a little bit cheaper for them to make. It is a little bit cheaper than making it in the US or Italy, and that's kind of the same with any products that you're making. But that still doesn't leave them with, like, this is kind of Kmart thing where, you know, you can buy a t-shirt from a brand that you love that could be made in the US for a plain white t-shirt for $50, for example. But of course you can also buy that same t-shirt from a Target or something for $10. Okay, let's say $10. If that's probably gonna be cheaper. A good quality one, let's say $10. It would have cost them a couple of dollars probably to make, maybe not even that. And it's probably maybe double that price for the other brand made in the US. So it might be $6 or $5. It depends on how many they're producing, but it will be a little bit more expensive. But there's still a huge profit margin for the US one. Like, they're still, it is like it costs them $30 to make that t-shirt, so they have to charge $50. There's a good profit margin there, and that's probably because they're more, their brand isn't meant to be cheap. You're just buying into the brand and that kind of thing. Whereas if you're buying from Kmart, you're saving a whole lot of money, but you're not getting the prestige or whatever of having that brand label or whatever. or whatever. So because the Target version of the t-shirt is a lot cheaper, you'll need to sell a whole lot more of them in order to make a decent profit. But you're more likely to sell a lot of them because they are so cheap. They are affordable and there isn't really a barrier to entry, as opposed to the, you know, US brand of t-shirt, which is say $50. You have to sell less of them to make a good profit, but you're less likely to sell a high volume because they are more expensive and there is that barrier to entry. Same thing with this makeup. And it's the same reason why e.l.f. was successful in the beginning. It's like, it's still great quality, but the brand is relying on a high volume of sales to make up for the lower profit margins. So I'm guessing that's what they're doing here. And same thing with all of Shein. Like, and Kmart, you go in there and you have one thing on your mind and you leave with 10 things because it's so affordable that it's like, why not? You're not having to invest much. You're not having to sacrifice much. So you can rationalize the decision and the purchase much more easily than if you went into a Maya or a David Jones and everything's like quadruple, 100 times the price, and you can't justify it because it's a lot more expensive. That's what I think this is. That was a very long-winded way of saying that this is a great quality and they're probably not making much money per unit, but they can get away with it because they're probably selling a squillion of them. So it makes up for it. But these are the She Glam Lip Tint in Primp. God, the font is so small. I'm going cross-eyed. And Cheeky. I don't know which shade. Ooh, that is quite a purple shade, so I might skip that one for now. Ooh, that's weird. That's a weird lip tint color. I saw the doe foot and then I thought, oh, it's like, you know, that color, but the actual product itself is that color. So let's try this. What on earth? How will this tint my lips? It smells kind of alcohol-y. I'm really confused. Oh, it is changing my lip color, isn't it? A bit, actually. What's happening? Okay, so that reminds me of one of those products that like kind of adjusts to your lip, your natural lip color, because there is no way that's what I put on my lips at the start. I might like put a side-by-side bit of footage of me applying it just before and then what I'm looking at now, because that's like red now. I mean, it's just kind of, yeah. Let me turn off the light for you. It feels nice. It feels like a tint, but in like a balm formula. Does it smell like anything? It does smell a little bit, yeah, like it smells a little bit alcohol-y at the start. What happens if I wipe it off? Yeah, so it's that color. So it kind of changed, it kind of morphed. I'm so impressed. Honestly, just to finish the video, I'm going to go in with my new fave, Concrete Jungle. She Glam lip liner. Oh, stunning. I could go out of the house just like that. Like, I like how that looks. Just with lined lips. I am shocked to my core at that match. I am shocked to my core. No. Unbelievable. I have the same problem with this that I have with the Makeup by Mario one, which is that I don't like the applicator. It's hard to get precision with this because it's so balmy that it doesn't stay flat, and so like the tip of the applicator doesn't have any product there because I've been using it to create like a lip line, but that means that it wears down unevenly. God, that smell is so weird. Okay, again, just quickly, lights off. Let me turn off my light in front. Oh, it's gonna be rough. Turn it back on. Jiminy Crickets. Wow, can't believe that. And I mean, like, look at the products. They're all super cute. They're all like really aesthetic. I mean, look how cute they blend into my own backdrop and my shirt. Like, it's all really nice stuff. It's not, it doesn't feel cheap or tacky. This is on like any other makeup brand's level, like Too Faced, Tarte. Genuinely, I have not been this impressed in a long time. And part of it is just because there is no way of arguing with that price point. But when I think about it, like think about how huge Shein is and how many connections they would have. They probably know the best manufacturers in China to work with. So, like, how could it be bad? Anyway, that's my review. Wow, guys, I am gonna try their other products. I will see you all another time. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day. Bye, guys.